Professor David Weiss was a leading scientist in the area of cancer immunology and immunotherapy. In 1965, while conducting research at the University of California, Berkeley, he traveled to the Soviet Union to take part in a medical conference held in Sukhumi in the Soviet Republic of Georgia.
There was an Israeli embassy in Moscow, but the Soviets saw to it that the people of the Israeli embassy did not have real contact with any kehillah. There was always the Malshinim, Jews who under terrific pressure collaborated with the government. I had an invitation as a VIP. I had a passport that read, invited by the Soviet government, Academy of Medical Sciences, to be helped on all occasions, something to that effect. And that I had a freedom to make contact that the Israeli in the embassy did not have. An understanding that I had repeatedly, that the only real connection that Jews in the Soviet Union had then, when I was there in the 1965 period, with the outside world, were through Chabad. And Chabad was very, very hesitant to endanger those lines. That the Rebbe asked to see me, I was told afterwards by some of his Hasidim, they were astounded, because the lines of communication of Chabad with the Jews of the Soviet Union were tenuous and they were dangerous. I cannot tell you exactly how long I was with the Rebbe. It was at least 2.5 hours, it may have been more than three. The Rebbe wanted me to tell him about the Soviet, about Russia. I told the Rebbe that I had an appointment at 1:15 on a given day in Moscow. I walked into a revolving door at 1:14 and a half. And getting in at the last second into my compartment is somebody else who hands me tefillin and other things to distribute among Jews that I meet. This was somebody from the Israeli embassy. I told him the story about the meeting with this community of Gruzian Jews. There was a minyan in Sukhumi, it was an abandoned factory. And there are maybe 25, 30 people. And somebody gives me a prayer book, but nobody comes near me. And I managed to open a button of my shirt, and there are tzitziot. And I unwrapped the tefillin, and this older man with a beard looks at me, and he suddenly gives a cry, and he says, "Azoy bin der tefillin?" So I said, "Evade, kan fi yuna." And he screams, and he hugs me, and I passed in. So my darkon was not what the Soviet Academy gave me, but I came with my own tefillin. And my father taught me how to wrap them to look like kan fi yuna. It's a particular way that my father and grandfather had. The man who spoke Yiddish, the chacham of this Georgian community, had been in a Chabad yeshiva in the 1920s. I told his stories in detail. The Rebbe could ask questions. He didn't just take it superficially. He wanted to know. And the Rebbe said, I will ask you to take on yourself tefillin as something that you will talk about when you get to Eretz Yisrael. I said, I'll be proud to do that. So I've written about it. And I talk very often about it. I thought the Rebbe was finished with me. And at that point, he said, I'd like to talk to you about what you're doing in science. And what it turns out is that he talked with me about the current theory of what came to be known as tumor immunology. If the body has the mechanism to reject viruses and bacteria, or if you implant foreign tissue, it's rejected. Is the body not capable of recognizing a transformed cancer cell as alien and rejected? And maybe the reason we have cancer is that the immune mechanism doesn't function enough. Maybe there could be a way of attacking this part. He talked about the theory that became the basis of tumor immunology. That was then the center of the field. I still found it rather astounding, the depth of the questioning, and the depth of the understanding. And then I asked the Rebbe a question. Maybe it was a bit of a chutzpah, but I asked the Rebbe, who can call yourself one of your Hasidim? He said, I don't wear the clothing of a Chabadnik. I am not as careful about all Shmirat Mitzvot as the people who are your Shlichim are. Who calls himself a Chabadnik? And I said, I've been with you for several hours and I'm profoundly impressed. The Rebbe says, he smiled, I remember that very distinctly. And he put his arm on the desk and he said, ganz einfach, I remember this word, very simple. And then he said to me, if a person who can look back at the end of the day and feel that he has advanced ethically, morally, Jewishly, a small step above where he was at the beginning of the day, I'd be happy, I shall be glad, I will call one of my Hasidim. That was a very powerful message.